Hi, welcome to this R&R video on dry land swimming, the equipment you need. So this video is just a nice short one just to help you get together all the different bits and pieces that you might need to be able to do a dry land swimming session. Now, the most important bit of equipment to do some dry land swimming is a set of swim cords. Now, swim cords are essentially elasticated bands at varying tensions with handles. Ideally, in an ideal world, you get a set of bespoke swim cords. Finis make a great set. ProSwim make some, the ProSwim ones. They even have, instead of a handle like this, which is what the Finis have, they actually have a paddle that you slide your hand into to totally recreate the action of your hand when you're catching, pulling, and pushing. Now, when you get these, they come in varying degrees of tension. Now, you can use the swim specific ones, or you can go and buy a set of gym resistance bands. The ones I have are gym resistance bands, and you can get some quite fancy ones like this that have protective sleeves in case the rubber tubing snaps, or just really inexpensive ones. But when you get them, you ideally, if you don't know what level of resistance you need, you ideally want to get one of the full sets. They're usually got four different tensions, a light, a moderate, a strong, and a very strong. And they'll vary in the levels of resistance in terms of the resistance it gives from a kilogram or pound weightage. If you think you know already what you need, get the ones that you think you need. So in this case, from someone like myself, a strong set. But also, get yourself the set down. As you start doing longer repetitions and more sets of the dry land swimming exercises, you will fatigue. And it's really important that you can maintain good form. So though sometimes it feels like you're taking a step down and you're swallowing a bit of the ego, get that slightly easier set that's going to allow you to do longer repetitions and allow you to do your sets with correct form. So for me, even though I got the strong, I tend to do the majority of my sessions with the medium set. So swim bands are your first key piece. Now, if you can't buy any, you know, at the moment we are in the COVID-19 crisis and gym equipment and home training equipment have been bought and the shelves are empty on a lot of online retailers, you can also make your own set quite inexpensively. So what I've got here is two inner tubes where I cut the inner tubes in half and I cut them just before the valve, tied those two ends together to create two relatively long swim bands. And then when I want to use them, what I do is attach them to something. Now I'm going to attach them right now to my wife's piano. I'm not going to do a full set because the piano can't take the tension. But what you would then do, attach them to something, and then what I do is take the long vowels, hold the valve in the palm of my hand to create a bit of a handle, and wrap around. If you can get some foam, you can put some foam in there as well, and then voila, all of a sudden, you've got swim bands, okay? And then, unlike a normal set, you're probably gonna go a little further back to get the tension in them. Now, as I said, I'm not gonna pull really hard right now, just because of the fact that my wife's piano wouldn't exactly both take the pull, nor would I live the day. But you can create your own. So swim cords, first key asset to have. The next thing, which is a nice to have, but if you can't have, is a loop resistance band. So one of those resistance bands that you quite often put around your legs to do leg resistance sessions. And again, where this will come into play is helping do some activities to help strengthen your legs, to keep a nice strong kick developed. Outside of that, the next really big piece of equipment that you want is, in an ideal world, you want a weight bench or a swim bench. The weight bench or the swim bench will let you lay flat so that when you're doing your, especially your upper body and some of your kick exercises, you're really able to put yourself into a swimming position. And you're also forced to keep your arm with a nice high elbow because you can't drop it straight down to the ground. Now, before the COVID-19, I went to a pool, didn't have to do a lot of this. And by the time I went online, trying to get myself a weight bench, there wasn't one to be found online. So what alternatives can you use? One alternative is you can use another kind of bench. And you know, in this household, we do have a piano bench. So occasionally, when my better half isn't around, I pinch the piano bench so I can do these sessions. Because the piano bench, what it does, is it lets me lay nice and flat, so I can do my upper body, and I can also do kicking drills. Now again, in my house, all the strongman swimming happens when the better half's not looking. If you can't get a hold of a swim bench or a weight bench, and you don't have a piano bench that you can steal at home, something else that you can do that still allow you to be flat and do your swim exercises is a gym ball. Now, if you're gonna use the gym ball, some people call it a Swiss ball, I would use it with a chair. Because what you can do is use the chair to help stabilize you, the gym ball to help get you in a nice position to do your exercises, and then you'll be able to do your exercises with your bands. All right, now the last piece of equipment on the list for dry land swimming is actually something that's gonna help you warm up and stretch out, and that's a pole. Now, with respect to a pole, you could go and buy some plastic tubing, or you can just grab a broom, a mop, anything in the house that gives you a nice straight pole. And what you're gonna use the pole for is you're gonna use it to help stretch out and warm up. So the pole allows you to do some nice dynamic stretching, really work the shoulders and really help stretch yourself out. If you have a chance on the R&R Sport YouTube channel, you'll see a circuit session one with Alex and stretching with Mary. Mary does the entire stretching full body using a pole. It's an amazing session. So definitely one thing to grab and have ready for your dry land swimming. That's it equipment wise for dry land swimming. Look out for our dry land swimming videos and sessions, both strength and workouts.